Cheers, everyone.
We've mixed together five strangers who love to wine and dine.
You've got to juggle your balls and try not to drop them.
Over a week, they'll each take turns throwing the perfect dinner party.
Oh, you've eaten cyanide.
But this is competitive entertaining.
It was rank.
As they'll mark each other's efforts in secret.
If I put this in my mouth now, I don't want to puke.
So there's no holds barred.
You're worse than a two-year-old little kid.
As the host with the most will walk off with a £1,000 cash prize. It's the final dinner party of the competition in Cardiff, and tonight, the winner of the £1,000 prize will be revealed. Straight-talking working mum Susie Green kicked off the week by serving up a Welsh speciality, sheep's testicles.
Has this sort of broadened your culinary horizons?
Definitely. I would definitely eat sweetbreads.
The sweetbreads tickled her guests, who awarded Susie a very respectable 27 points.
It's a really tricky thing to make, isn't it?
On night two, B&B owner and psychic healer Annette Howard served up some traditional fare, but her special powers failed to register as she scored a disappointing 13.
It was rank.
Day three saw laid-back university lecturer Jim Blythe cook a banquet of the exotic and unusual.
Now you've eaten the mandrocker and said that's poisonous.
I look quite daunted now.
And his gamble paid off as his South Pacific feast put him top of the class with an impressive 34 points. Yesterday was the turn of socialist postman Charlie Balch, who hosted a night of organic fare and local Welsh produce.
Never had mutton before, and we'll never eat it again.
He posted a score of 29 points to put him in second place. So the only person who can topple Jim is tonight's host, outgoing nurse and Welsh patriot Jane Lloyd, who just wants to give everyone a good time.
Tonight, the atmosphere hopefully will be relaxed and people enjoy themselves.
Well, let's hope so, because it's been some week. On Monday, Charlie and Annette fell out.
I don't know what your problem is, but it's...
No problem, Charlie, other than you.
But on Tuesday, they kissed and made up.
Yourself, how's your day been, all right?
Oh, Matt.
Yeah, I bet.
On Wednesday, it was Jane's turn to fall out with Annette.
Very bitter. You've got no man in your life.
I don't have a man in my life, is that what you're telling me?
Well, you're desperately seeking the sugar.
Evening, Annette.
Hello.
All right.
But last night, they buried the hatchet.
There was a slight feeling of everybody trying to be on their best behaviour, having sort of maybe slightly misbehaved themselves the night before.
There weren't any arguments last night.
We all got on pretty well last night.
So, fingers crossed for tonight, eh?
I'm really looking forward to seeing everyone tonight. It's the last night, so it's sort of, you know, a bit exciting to see who will win.
Let's just have a nice evening. Hopefully they enjoy my food. Yeah, just enjoy it, really, not get too stressed. Let's just go for it.
Watch this space. Cardiff Bay. As well as being one of the most dynamic and upcoming areas in the Welsh capital, it's also home to today's host, and Nurse Jane is a true compatriot.
Food tonight, I think, has a bit of a Welsh slant.
Clearly. As Jane's starter is that well-known Welsh delicacy, potted prawns.
My recipe is for my gran, but apparently she got it from a packet of some food years ago.
So the prawn motif has returned. After a brief absence at Charlie's, we're back on the prawns.
It's unfortunate. I wish people would be a bit more experimental in the starter.
The starters hardly set the pulses racing, so what do the guests hope the main course might be?
She might do a pasta dish. We haven't had a pasta dish all week, which has surprised me, to be honest. I thought we'd have maybe at least one pasta dish, so perhaps a pasta dish.
So you reckon a pasta dish then, Charlie? Wrong! When in Wales, there can only be one thing on the menu.
Lamb.
Yep, it's roast lamb, or coesigoyn rost in Welsh, served with ratatouille and potatoes.
Coesigoyn rost. Can't say that properly.
Yeah, I think she needs some help here, guys.
Coesigoyn rost.
Beautifully said.
Coesigoyn rost. So it's roast lamb, I believe. Am I correct? Of course you know I'm correct.
All right, smarty pants, no one likes a know-it-all.
Anchovies actually go very well with lamb, and that's one that you wouldn't immediately think of, but they really work.
Don't like those little monkeys, no.
You got the right menu there.
ratatouille, I'm just wondering if it's going to be too tomato-y to go with the garlic and the rosemary.
Hmm, so the prognosis for Welsh patriot Jane's menu isn't too good so far. Maybe her traditional dessert of vanilla panna cotta with blueberry coulis will win them over. Could have sworn that was Italian.
Vanilla is good. Blueberry coulis would be very interesting to try. Never had it.
So it's not going to be too sweet, which doesn't surprise me because she's not that sweet at all.
And what else do the guests think Jane will prescribe tonight?
I feel Jane's dinner party is going to be quite an upbeat atmosphere. Lots of alcohol, because she's quite a good time, fun time girl.
I think Jane would produce the sort of dinner party where the booze flows pretty freely.
Yep, tonight's certainly not going to be nil by mouth, as Jane pops down to her local vineyard for some wine. And yes, there is a vineyard in Wales.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Hi.
I'm doing a very Welsh menu. Well, I like the Welsh touch coming through my meal tonight. Right. So obviously with your wine, it'll give me that extra Welsh edge. So if you could help me out.
This is quite dry.
No, it's pleasant, nice.
Yeah.
And Jane hopes to find the perfect remedy to get into Annette's good books.
We have a lady at coming tonight who only drinks Veuve Clicquot.
This is called Carriad Blush, and it's literally a pink champagne. We can't call it champagne because right. It's not grown in the Champagne region. To really just drink one champagne all the time is a bit boring,
isn't it?
Yeah, it is, yeah. So let's educate her in that there are other sparkling wines out there in the world.
Exactly. And, that's nice. I think it's nice to have a bit of Welsh wine with my meal. Hopefully it'll add some points onto the old score.
Having stocked up on some Welsh elixir, Jane heads back home. And with the panna cotta needing 8 hours to set, she starts on her dessert by adding 10 tablespoons of milk to a pot of cream. She then gently heats the mixture before adding the seeds of 2 vanilla pods.
I am cutting open my vanilla pod to get the seeds out. So they infuse in the old milk and cream. Gelatin leaves, which obviously helps it all stick together. Just soak them in. But cold water, have done a bit of a boob with hot water and they just melt away.
Jane's using gelatin leaves instead of powder as they're easier to dissolve and leave no lumps. She then measures out 200 grams of caster sugar before adding it to the simmering mixture.
Right, off the heat and then add your sugar. Marvel, marvel, marvel.
In go the soaked gelatin leaves, which have now softened.
And they just melt away. Got sieve action now. So just sieve it through to your vanilla pods.
Oh, you mucky pup.
Pour it into moulds.
While the panna cotta starts to set, Jane has time to do her afternoon rounds.
There we go. No drama. This is obviously the living room, where we like to chill out, relax, watch the telly. I live here with my flatmate, Michelle, who owns the flat, so it's pretty much her decor, minimal, but it's very comfy and cosy.
And it's quite interesting because I've delivered sort of priority services and stuff to these buildings, but never actually looked inside, so I'm quite looking forward to having a look inside a bay flat, like, you know?
I've got some data in because it adds to the Welsh theme of the food, so it just follows it all through. So you've got the Welsh atmosphere of the daffs, and another bit of lamb.
My guess would be that, like me, she thinks that housework is what you do when you haven't got anything else to do. And by the time you get around to cleaning the toilet, you haven't got a friend left in the world.
This is obviously my room. It's clean, tidy-ish. Not much in it, so it doesn't need a lot of faff. I painted that for my dad when we lived in Scotland, thistles. It's quite nice, actually, if I do say so myself.
Mmm! Back in the kitchen, Jane starts to prepare the ratatouille by chopping up some onions, garlic and aubergines.
Let me cover the aubergine with salt. Draws out the bitterness of the aubergine.
She then adds some peppers.
I've never looked at a recipe for ratatouille. It's just come from Mother.
Jane then chops up some courgettes before tackling the tomatoes.
I'm putting the tomatoes in boiling water to soften the skin and peel away the skin. I take the skin off because A, it doesn't look very attractive, bits of skin floating in the ratatouille and they get stuck in your teeth. Now just leave it simmer, bubble away, and all the veg will just combine together and come into a bit more mushiness.
Next, it's time for the lamb.
The anchovies enhances the flavour of the lamb.
The rosemary and garlic just kind of permeates through the lamb and it just gives it a nice flavour.
And now a political broadcast on behalf of Welsh lamb.
It winds me up a bit, people buying New Zealand lamb, because they should be buying Welsh, keeping, you know, Welsh produce, keeping it going. Michelle's dad's a farmer, so, you know, give him a bit of support. It's all good.
The lamb's now ready and will be roasted for 90 minutes before serving. Jane now turns her attention to her other veg, potatoes boulangerie. How exactly is that Welsh?
It is slightly on a French slant, but I thought something had to support the ratatouille. And also, I'm sure, maybe a little Welsh heritage, maybe in France. You never know.
Clutching at straws, perhaps? Jane sliced the potatoes and layers them on top of each other with chopped onions, rosemary and seasoning added in between.
Just got to add the stock, the vegetable stock, and a bit of milk and butter on top, and then it's ready to whack in the oven.
Finally, Jane prepares the potted prawns. She places some prawns into a ramekin, pours in a good glug of cream, covers them in breadcrumbs before putting a knob of butter on top and covering in paprika.
I think it's important, if you're going to have entertain, to enjoy yourself as well, so have something that's quite easy, pop it in the oven, that you can go and enjoy yourself as well, so you're not faffing all the time.
It's 6:30, and with all her faffing done, Jane greets her guests.
Evening, Annette. How are you?
I'm fine.
All right.
Fine.
Well, I thought it was a samba rhythm. How are you doing?
Good, thanks.
Oh, look, both wrap dresses.
Oh, how are you, darling?
I'm good, you?
Yeah, I'm fine, thank you.
Didn't quite hear you the first time.
OK, here we are. How are you,
I'm good, thanks. You? We're going Dutch.
Oh, we're going Dutch.
Marvellous. Come on through. It's through to your left.
Through to my left?
Yes.
This is nice. Oh, not that then.
Oh, some people are just so funny.
Coming up, Annette feels the heat.
In there now is a conversation going on, which I'm totally being excluded from.
Temperatures boil over.
You're worse than a two-year-old little kid.
Before the winner of the £1,000 is revealed. It's the final night of the competition in Cardiff, and lecturer Jim Blythe is leading the chase for the £1,000 prize. But this evening's host, Nurse Jane Lloyd, hopes her Welsh-themed evening, kicking off with some local bubbly, will send her fizzing into first place.
OK, guys, the end of the week. It's been a good week, I think, but it's time to last hurdle for our stomachs, I think. So, yakida.
Yakida, indeed. And before Jane heads to the kitchen, she sets her guests a challenge.
So the challenge is, can you guess which bedroom is mine? Because I live here with my flatmate, Michelle. So can you see which one is which?
Mm. Well, either she sort of swapped things in here to fool us.
Can you not tune into your inner energy vibe and assess whether this is Jane's room or not?
Well, it's quite difficult when there's two... What's that there? Oh, it's a little... Is that a bunny?
It's a kangaroo, isn't it?
Yeah, but I've got my glasses on again.
OK.
Ah, no, sister's uniform. That's a sister,
I think. Top floor chest, 45 to 47.
47 chest? It's Jordan's flat.
I don't think it is. Having put the ramekins in the oven for 12 minutes, Jane's kicking off the evening by serving potted prawns.
I see we've got enough cutlery to go around, unlike my house. Splendid.
Now, we're continuing on the caveat wine.
Great, yeah.
So I've been advised that this is the way forward.
It was a lovely touch having Welsh wine. I've never had it before, but it's definitely a wine I'd buy again.
There is some very good wine being produced in Wales. And that certainly, you know, what Jane chose, the wine that she chose for the meal, was very good and it worked very well.
So, guys, you've had a little poke around the old bedrooms.
Mm-hmm. Your room is the one on the left. Now, I didn't sneak around your wardrobe.
Right.
But
right. Somebody did they?
Size 14.
Right. Yeah. Gives it away, doesn't it? Could you not have picked something that said 12?
Well, we did look
at 12. There's tops that say 12, but you had to go for the 14.
No, sorry.
Size 14 is a very respectable size.
So, obviously, guys, you're absolutely right. My bedroom is on the left, and Michelle is the pinky girl on the right.
The prawn starter was really delicious. It was hot prawns, which I like,
crunchiness, absolutely fab.
But it was a different take on prawns. I mean, the two previous prawn dishes were cold, so it was nice to have prawns prepared in a different way.
So, does anyone actually know what the main course is? Except for the ratatouille and the potatoes.
I think it's something with chicken.
Chicken?
Was it lamb or
good? Yeah, I think it's roast lamb.
Roast lamb.
Yeah.
Good to go. Yeah. Good to go. Good to go. Good to go. Well done, guys.
Yeah.
It's roast lamb again.
Welsh roast lamb. Yeah, Welsh roast lamb.
We're going to be far in the end of this week.
Yeah. Having been in the oven for over 90 minutes, the lamb's looking a tad burnt. So what's the diagnosis?
I'd suggest it was a little bit tough.
If you want to know how to burn Welsh lamb, or how not to, all Jane's recipes are on the Channel 4 website. For her main course, Jane is serving roast leg of lamb with potatoes boulangerie and ratatouille.
Watch yourself.
Okay. I don't cook Welsh food all the time, but I usually do it if I've got foreign guests. If any of my, my foreign friends come over, I'll do Welsh food for them. So I'll do, you know, having Welsh things on the menu is probably a very good thing. People associate Wales with sheep, and you can't eat coal, and that's the only other, or daffodils. Those are the other major things.
Potatoes were then lovely. Ratatouille was perfect. Excellent.
If it was a very strong tomato-y ratatouille, then it might sort of overtake the sweetness of the lamb. But it amazingly worked.
It's not just so much about Welsh food. It's all about local food.
Yeah.
It's all about cooking, is it?
Yeah.
It's more to life than food.
It's not... No.
So we've just got to talk about food. We can talk about other things as well.
No, but the point is, I think, if we use local produce and then we can all get something different, completely different out of it.
After a week talking about food, Annette's had enough.
Whether you're paid or you're not paid.
You think long hours is important? Whatever. I don't think long hours is important. I'd rather work short hours and spend more time, at home and with family.
What we're saying is, I work long hours as nurse. I do 3 days a week and I work 2 long shifts.
In there now is a conversation going on, which I'm totally being excluded from. I will not interrupt because I feel like it's rude. So because I can't voice what I need to voice, it's getting stuck in my throat chakra, and that's what's causing me to cough. I haven't got a cough. I do not wish to put myself in a position of being attacked again. That's why I've got a crystal on my bra, the black one, for protection.
We were having quite an animated conversation about food generally, and she suddenly decided she didn't want to talk about food and she didn't want us to talk about food.
Nanette kind of disappears and has a fake coughing fit to get a bit of attention.
With her chakra calmed, Annette returns.
This conversation is just about food.
Personally,
this conversation could be about other things.
I haven't got a problem with being a foodie. I think being a foodie is quite good.
Clearly, Annette's still not impressed and gets up to leave the table again.
Just sit down join in the conversation. You must have a love of food, right? We're talking about food. No matter
it's
what,
common
what
interest.
Yeah, whatever you. This is okay, one thing that connects with all of us.
No, we're not trying to lecture you, but...
Oh, I think you are.
But I can't understand why you were stamping your feet because you were talking about food. But it's supposed to be a common word that we've all got.
I will go in the lounge now.
Well, we're all going for a fag in a minute, okay. So I just sit tight.
Well, you fag away. I will go in the lounge now and have a little quiet time to myself.
But you're not actually giving me a bit of...
I'm not getting into an altercation with you. That's why I'm going to go and sit in there.
I've asked you nicely. Do a favour to Jane. She spent all day cooking, right? You're worse than a 2-year-old little kid.
She's
you are worse than a 2-year-old.
I've had one marriage, 40 years.
I've got to be honest.
What?
I've got to be honest.
Annette.
I'll be writing to the pub next week and getting tannanized.
Charlie.
You must be a f***ing saint.
Charlie, don't rise to the bait, please. Everybody, I'm sorry. Would you like to eat your pudding next door?
No, I'm just going to sit in the lounge because I would like to
see you even in my pudding.
Another quiet night in Cardiff.
I think Jane has been put in an appalling position. I think Annette has behaved absolutely abominably.
I've got to be truthful. If she'd behaved like that last night, I would have physically marched her out of my house and put her in a taxi.
This is a 57-year-old woman. I'm 31, and I would not treat people like this.
Whichever way you want to look at it, I would turn that around. I would never, ever, ever make anyone feel unwelcome in my home.
And after all that, there's still the dessert to get through.
Okay. All we're doing is dipping it in hot water so it releases the old panna cotta. Oh, sweetie, don't cry. Don't let it make you cry.
To sweeten the atmosphere, Jane serves up vanilla panna cotta with blueberry coulis.
Annette, whether you want it or not, here's pudding. And it is quite pleasant if you'd like to try it.
Thank you for the gesture, Jane.
Except yourself entirely.
I think it's really
good. I don't want answers, to be honest.
It looks fantastic, I've got to be honest.
That's really good, yeah. Mm.
It's fantastic, though.
Do you want a sort of very traditional thing? You know,
Totally.
Well, when I saw the menu, it said...
The dessert was absolutely great. I really enjoyed the dessert. It was a really light, creamy panna cotta, and the sharpness of the blueberries just softened the sweetness slightly.
There was no crumbness on the plate.
With an uneasy truce descending over the guests, it's time for the scores.
So I've decided to give Jane an 8. It's not quite a 9 because it's a personal prejudice, maybe, but I thought mixing the Welsh and the French on the same plate didn't quite gel for me.
Tonight, I'm going to give Jane a 7. It was lovely food, but nothing really that had the wow factor, but it was still great food.
Tonight, I'm going to give Jane an 8. I've had a wonderful evening. The food has been lovely. The lamb was a little bit overcooked for my liking, which is why I've come up with this score. But generally, it's been a good evening. She's been a great host.
For her food, I would give her a 10. For her hostessing abilities, I will give her a 0. So, therefore, she has a 0.
So, Jane ends the week with a score of 23 points. And it's now time for her to reveal who's won the £1,000.
5th place, Annette. 4th place, Jane. 3rd place, Susie.
I predicted that.
2nd place, Charlie. Ooh. And in 3rd place... Jim,
have you a plate of dollars?
Oh,
well
done.
Thank
you. I'm really impressed. Thank you all very much.
And the best person. Just,
for people who are really into food, to think that what I'd done was the best was, well, quite moving and a very flattering, and it was lovely.
Jim absolutely deserved to win. He cooked a wonderful meal. He pushed the boundaries. We all tried something different, and I'm thrilled for him.
Well, I came 4th, which isn't bad. Although it nudges on Annette, it is not that bad.
From day one, I knew I was going to come last because they were all going to gang up and do whatever they wanted to. But that's not the problem.
I could and will be having plenty more occasions where I'll be sitting down over food with, you know, all of the others. But I will never, ever be seeing Annette again.
What I'd like to do with the money is take these guys out for a really nice meal somewhere. If we can figure somewhere where we can beat up the chef and get his recipes, that would be great.
A curvy, light-filled manor house grand design has endless problems that become a health hazard for its owner.
Ranging
about 5 to 8. And next up, join Amanda Lamb in the south of France at a palatial £1 million place in the sun.
Take care.